So lots of people interested in making a real difference to doing practical conservation. And in doing so, they very often turn to guidance. You know, let's look at the best practice as to what works and what doesn't work. But there are serious problems with how guidance operates. And that's what we'd like to discuss here. So I'm here with Dave Watson, who's the leading expert on mistletoes. And the Royal Horticultural Society has produced guidance on how to grow mistletoe. They've got seven bits of guidance. Firstly, harvest berries from a tree in March or April. Make sure you choose a tree that's similar to the type of tree in your own garden that you wish to establish the mistletoe on. What do you think?
Disagree. If ever there's ripe fruit, that's a good time to use it, and it can be on any tree, a tree of many species. It most definitely doesn't have to be from the species that mistletoe was growing on originally.
Okay, there's no evidence for that. Yeah. Discard any crushed berries and do not use berries from sprigs used as Christmas decorations. These will not germinate as they're generally harvested when immature.
That depends. And I think it's a bit like when you have avocados at the supermarket, just give it a squish test. If it's too hard, you don't want to eat that. But if it's nice and squishy, that's good to go. Squish out the seed and that seed should be fine.
Number three, choose a branch 10 centimetres or more in girth on a tree that is 15 years old or more. Ideally, this should be fairly high up so the developing plant receives plenty of light.
That's a 50-50. So yes for the tree, but no for the branch. You need a thin branch, about as thick as a pencil, no thicker than your forefinger.
Find a natural crevice in the bark or make a shallow cut to create a small flap.
Wrong, 100% wrong. You want to do it on the underside of a branch where it'll where dew will congregate. Don't cut anything.
Remove the seeds from the fleshy berries and insert them into the crevice or under the flap.
Don't put it under anything. Just be the bird. Just wipe it on there. It needs to be in a well-lit environment.
Finish by covering with hessian to protect the seeds from birds.
Terrible advice. So it's a photosynthetically active seed. It's a green seed. It needs to be in a well-lit area to power its own growth and establishment.
To ensure greater success, sow quite a few seeds at each site, as only 1 in 10 seeds germinate, and both male and female plants are needed for berries to form.
Agreed.
So so we have seven bits of advice, one of which says grow quite a few seeds. All the others are contradicted by the science. And am I right in saying this isn't new science? This is actually well-established science.
It is well-established science, especially for that species of mistletoe, one of the best-known mistletoes in the world.
So we do have this curious problem, and Harriet Downey did a review of the 200 bits of guidance in the UK and showed that this was typical, that the guidance very often isn't based on the evidence, isn't based on the research, often contradicts each other, very often is wrong. And I know you've been involved in creating guidance for mistletoe, so did you use the evidence?
We did. So we went straight to the horse's mouth. There's a lot of native plant enthusiasts out there who've done a lot of trial and error, who've kept very detailed notes. We prepared a great little guide to help interested people plant mistletoes around their place. We did that for 7 species of mistletoe in eastern Australia, and that will then be adapted for mistletoes in other parts of Australia, other parts of the world. But yeah, it's that knowledge is out there, so let's get it together in a reputable way, share it.
And it's kind of weird that if you provided medical advice and you just, you know, a reputable organisation just invented it, it would be unthinkable. And yet somehow reputable organisations do produce stuff which just contradicts the known science.
Indeed. And it's a bad look.
Indeed, yeah, yeah. So what do you hope will happen with the guidance you're producing on how to grow mistletoe? What's your hope as to the way forward?
Sure. So what our hope is for the broader community to embrace mistletoe as a lovely native plant. You can go to the nursery and buy all sorts of plants. Because of its unique parasitic habit, you have to plant it yourself. It's not that hard. You can do it for free and spread the love.
So I guess we're saying there's two messages. First message is we need evidence-based guidance, and that not using evidence is a terrible thing to do, and that's a deeply serious problem, and it leads to ineffective conservation. And I guess the second message, and I think you're particularly thinking of urban areas like this, I know it's a bit dark, but there's lots of isolated trees here.
Perfect.
They'll be perfect for mistletoe to grow in, and it'd be fabulous to have a lot more mistletoe going here. And And if we, mistletoe is famous in Britain for being difficult to grow, but actually I think what you're saying is the problem is that the guidance is wrong, and that if we know how, if we followed the science, it would work.
Easy peasy.
Yeah, so let's have a lot more mistletoe. Let's have evidence-based guidance.
Huzzah.